This is my first video and I knew nothing about editing, so I messed it up. So I had to redo the video and the project was already done. So here it goes. My first project is that cute little barn you just saw. It's adorable. I was so excited to do it. Anyway, I'm going to use those paint sticks from Walmart, my glue gun, this baby blanket from Dollar Tree, any piece of cardboard you want, Waverly chalk paint, which is also from Walmart, Sharpie. Can't guarantee everything is going to be from Dollar Tree. Some glue sticks, a paintbrush. Measurements are, you need two sticks cut to 8.5 inches, one stick cut to 11.75 inches, two sticks cut to 5 inches, and one stick cut to 5.75 inches. It makes it a lot easier that I'm giving you the measurements because it was a little time consuming trying to figure out the barn. Here I have my baby blanket already wrapped around the cardboard. I just traced the barn after I did it. I took my silhouette machine. Here comes my cat. That's Rosie. Hi, Rosie. I took my silhouette machine and I printed out farmhouse. I cut out farmhouse and I ironed it on the baby blanket. That was actually my first thing I ironed on and it turned out pretty good. Bye, Rosie. Say hi to everybody. Hi. Okay, bye, Rosie. Okay, so I take my farmhouse and I put it back together with my glue gun. And I'm also going to glue it to the baby blanket. So it doesn't matter what you do first. You can glue the roof on first or you can glue it on the blanket. Doesn't matter. This is so adorable, and I was so excited to make it. You know, it took me about 3 weeks to make this first video. I researched, I obsessed with everybody's videos. I watched, that's all I do is watch DIY home videos. I love you guys. Okay, so now, excuse me, I'm gluing it to the baby blanket. Oh, by the way, I meant to tell you, I made this little wreath. I just bought some greenery from Walmart. I took a piece of wire and I made a circle. And I got some ribbon, some lace ribbon from Dollar Tree. And I made a little bow and a little hanging piece to hang it. I thought that was the final adorable touch to it. Wait till you see how this turns out. So cute, if I do say so myself. So I'm almost done gluing my, oh, there I go. I glue the cord to the, you know, I don't know about you guys, but do you guys drop stuff and, you know, knock over stuff? And I mean, I don't know what my problem is, but I'm always messing things up. And I'm like, all right, cut. And I have to re-film it. I'm a mess. I'm just a big, hot mess. just trying to pick some extra glue off of here. It should be just about dry. I'm just gonna put a little bit more glue over here on the side. And then should be about done here. I'm gonna pick it up and show you what it looks like. And this is my little farmhouse barn. I think it's just adorable. But I forgot to glue the little bow on. I found it later. I think it falls off right about here. But I don't see it till later. So I glue the little ribbon that I have holding the wreath on to the back. And all I need to do now is just put a piece of wire or some sort of hanger. You can see the bow was over there on the corner. But that's okay, I put it back on later. I don't even notice that it fell off. So I apologize for that. Okay, so my next project is gonna be this really cool thing I found for the pool. I don't have a heater in my pool, so I saw an idea to put garbage bags in the pool. And it would attract the sun, and the sun would heat the pool. Okay, so I got these, I said, but the garbage bags kept bushling up and messing up and getting caught in the filter. So I saw this idea online and decided to show you guys, for those of you who haven't seen it. Okay, so I got this hula hoop and these foam pieces from Dollar Tree. Noodles. I forgot what they were called. So I spent $2 on this project. I already had the garbage bag. So of course scissors don't work on this, so I get my razor. And it was so easy. I mean, it probably took me about 10 minutes to do this project. But eventually I'll probably make about 8 of them. I bought, I think, 6 hula hoops. But you just cut a piece of the noodle. I used the whole garbage bag on one, but you could always cut the garbage bag in half and not waste. You just put a slit down the side, and this is what's going to hold the garbage bag on the floor. I swear, people are genius. Where they come up with these ideas is amazing. So I cut about 6 or 7 of these, and I just keep going. I'll get used to this. I will eventually get this down pat, for sure. I don't know what I'm totally doing yet, but I'll get it. Okay, so I project is just a little shelf that I saw on Pinterest, and I had already stained the shelf, and I had some chicken wire in the garage, and I wanted to have three projects for you, so I figured I would do this last one. It's cute. It's not one of my favorites, but it's okay. It's really pretty. Okay, so I am going to use this one shelf.
Yes.
Not sure which one, the bigger one or smaller one. Probably the bigger one. Some chicken wire.
Yes.
This is the chicken wire that I had in the garage. I'm going to use these little sticks from the Dollar Tree. My glue gun, of course. Trusty glue gun. Some scissors. This is a stain right there. It's my go-to stain, mahogany. I love it.
Brush.
I love the red in it. A paintbrush. And scissors. And that's about it. Okay, so I start by cutting my chicken wire, and I started out using my little wire cutters. Then I realized it cuts by using scissors. So it was so much easier than I thought. I'm measuring the width across with these sticks. This chicken wire is the exact width of the wood board. So I really didn't have to cut any of the width part, or the height part rather. So what I do is I put three pieces of this these sticks on the top, and I just twist the wire around the board. I'm sorry. So after I stapled my chicken wire to the back of my board, I added my skewers to the sides and the back. One straight up the back, one diagonal, and one across the bottom. This was pretty easy. I just snipped them with my wire cutters, and I used my glue gun. This is my project. I hope you enjoyed watching me. If you enjoyed it, please hit the like button, subscribe to my channel, leave some comments. I would love to talk to you. So I hope you enjoyed my projects. This was my very first video. If you did, please hit the like button, hit the subscribe button, and the bell so you can be notified every time I put new videos out. I have lots of ideas. Also, comment if you'd like to. I'd love to hear from you. I'll see you next time. Thank you so much for watching.
Thank you.